thing called love. I just can't handle it. This thing called love. I must get around to it. I ain't ready. This crazy little thing called love. This thing called love. It cries in the cradle all night. It swings. It jives. It takes all over like a jellyfish. I kinda like it. Crazy little thing called love. There goes my baby. She knows how to rock and roll. She drives me crazy. She gives me hot and cold fever. Then she leaves me in a cold, cold sweat. I gotta be cool. Relax, get hip, get on my tracks, take a back seat, hitchhike, take a long, long ride on my motorbike till I'm ready. A crazy little thing called love. Take a bob. Relax, get hip, get on my track, take a back seat, hitchhike, take a long, long ride on my motorbike till I'm ready. Crazy little thing called love. 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 Called love, called love. Crazy little thing called love.
Well, it could go on and on and
we
on.
We could just keep going on. Is this
I know,
repeats?
Right? Let me just tilt this down a little
tilting
bit.
Tilting yourself down. There you
there
are.
There we go. There we go. Hi, Michael.
Hey, Bob.
That was kind of the perfect song to open with tonight. We have a really bizarre eclectic mix of songs tonight. Songs
a
I really love.
Mix. Yes, that's right.
Crazy. But we have a lot of love. A lot of love. Yes. Stuff involving love. Not sappy love songs, but a lot of... songs about feeling good and love and happiness.
We don't. We have Claudia, who's become a little sort of a regular. She pops up like once a month, right? We love that. We have, you know, Zach, who's never been here. Right?
Zach, I know. We finally got to meet Zach Taglioli.
Right. We have Jay, who we haven't seen in a very, very long time, and we have my dear friend Karen, who I'm so excited to see her. So, what a fun group we have.
It's a fun
studio.
Group already. Yeah. Happy hour started during rehearsals.
For most.
And Jeff Goffman's out there watching us. Hi, Jeffrey and Aileen and Gail and Patricia and Michelle and Marjorie and Penny and Judy and Dottie and everybody. I can't reach to scroll back to see everyone I missed. But anyway, so we're going to have a lot of fun tonight. What do you think? We should just get started?
Well, I can look to see who you missed. You missed Steve Long. Dennis
Steve Rue. Long, who sang with me last night in Asbury Park.
Dennis and Sandy.
And Jack Putnick. Yes.
And Jane Stevens from the UK, checking in.
Vincent, I saw us there from Chicago.
Sharon Freeman, I assume Christina's there too. And Leslie Perkel, Leslie from Oklahoma.
Yay, the green chair lady.
Yeah.
And hi, Jimmy Two Kings.
Yeah. Let's see.
I saw Jimmy last night too. The Asbury was hopping.
Really Tom Chiola, you said mentioned Judy Jones, Jack Putnack.
John Chiola's going to be on the
your
show
cousin Patty,
coming up.
Penny Katz and Rachel Wyfall. And
it's not Penny Katz, it's Penny Katz.
Barry Reed, Wally Watson, boy, Michael and Bennett Lee are out there, and Patricia from Atlantic City. Nice. Is Jeff checking in from Florida?
That's right.
There you go.
Palm Beach.
Mary Helen Morris. Hi, Mary
Tyler,
Helen.
Tyler, Texas.
She says it's hot in Texas. Mary Ellen, it's hot.
It's too darn
hot. It's been hot here, too.
Too darn hot.
It finally cooled down. All that rain we had, it finally cooled down.
Yeah, well, it's hot in here. I'll tell you that. It's not. Make sure I get the right key for our next rendering.
That's the trick, right? Rehearsal, you go through like a mile a minute, like literally.
Uh-huh.
A mile a minute.
And a lot happens in about an hour and 15 minutes.
Who could remember what we did an hour ago?
I don't know. Anyway. So anyway, I hope you all enjoyed our show. Let's say hi to our first guest. Jay Walensky is here live in person.
Yay! Hi, Jay.
Hello.
So, Jay, you were in the studio one time, I think, right?
One time before.
And that's a long time
ago. And really
ago.
And he still came back.
Yeah.
Came back anyway. Yes.
He came back anyway.
Now, this is a thrill. This is a privilege.
And the last time I saw you, you were out singing, I think it was in Moonstruck, and Marie Chantel was with you.
Yeah. And, I'm lucky enough that she's usually with me.
And she sings lovely, too, and you usually do nice duets together. And she sings beautifully by herself. But it's nice. So hello to Marie. I'm sure she's watching.
Hello, Marie.
Yeah. So you're going to have to lean in when you speak, because you're
will do.
Yeah. He's got the perfect song to start our show, too. This is hopefully it's true, Jay, too. Hopefully the best is yet to come.
Well, that's it's
been pretty good so far.
We'll just go with that. Jay Valensky.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? You think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day of mine. Come the day of mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. Tasted the wine. We're gonna drain that cup dry. Wait till your charms are right for these arms to surround. You think you've flown before, but babe, you ain't left the ground. Wait till you're locked in my embrace. Wait till I draw you near. Wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. The best is yet to come, and babe, won't it be fine? The best is yet to come, come the day of mine. Come the day of mine. And you're gonna be mine.
Thank you, Bob.
The silky sounds of Jay Valensky. It was. It's like, I love the fact that it's like sort of this silky old. We have a lot of silky old fashioned singing tonight, Bob, I think.
Yes, we do. Yeah. Oh, yes, we do.
Yes, we do. We do.
Yes, we do. Hi, Kevin Pressey. I saw you just joined us too. And Dottie's out there. And Gail Moore.
And David and Linda Cogger checking in, too.
Yes, Your Kind of Music tonight, guys. It's Your Kind of Music. You're going to know every song in tonight's show.
So why'd you pick this next song? I love to hear why people chose particular songs.
The next one?
Yeah.
It just has the best groove I've ever heard. That groove, you don't do it too fast, and you just settle in, and it rocks, and it's a beautiful thing.
In fact, I'm not going to say anything about it much now, but this would count, Michael, as yacht rock.
See, I'm on this yacht rock. Anyone who's watching the show, I said we should do a yacht rock show.
Oh, we're
Zach's
doing
in it. Right? And Bob goes, what the heck is that? You know, I'm like, there's a whole station on
Saturday. August 16th.
This is all right. So now we're doing it. See,
August 16th.
This is kind of yacht rock. I agree. So doing the yacht rock debut on Virtual Piano Bar, Jay Walensky.
Hey, let me just note, Bob's friend, Kenny Rankin, just nailed this song.
Oh,
just
yeah, that's
yeah,
right.
That's
Kenny
true.
Did have a great version of this.
All right.
That's right. I forgot that.
down with Bob Egan, they got lots of pretty women. Steal your money and they'll break your heart. Lonesome Sue, she's in love with old Sam. Take him from the fire into the frying pan. On and on, she'll just keep on trying. And she'll smile when she feels like crying. On and on, on and on, on and on. Lonesome Jimmy sits alone in the moonlight. Saw his woman kiss another man. So he take a ladder, steal the stars from the sky. Put on Sinatra and he start to cry. On and on, he'll just keep on trying. And he'll smile when it feels like dying. On and on, on and on, on and on. Now when the first time is the last time, it can make you feel so bad. Say good night,
Professor Egan.
Jay Valenski.
Thanks, everybody.
I had to refrain myself from singing along. Jay, thanks, Jay.
Because you probably knew every word, right?
Well, and the neat thing is it just cries out for that third, right, the whole time. On and on, on and on, on and on.
Let's do it again, Jay.
Yeah. No, anyway.
Just, I'm done. Now I can finish my drink. Hi, Pat Adeoni. It's your kind of music tonight, too. We have a lot of songs you're going to know and love.
Yeah.
So I'll tell you real quick while we're at it. Next week, we're doing Andrew Lloyd Webber. We have a few people coming that have never been here live before. Like John Ward is going to be here, and he's out there watching tonight. And Kathy Liebars is coming as well. And others. I haven't looked at that list yet. And then August 2nd, I will be away because I'll be playing up in Cape Cod. So we will miss one show with you all on August 2nd and then nothing else till the unforeseen future. Then we have a variety show. We have our Yacht Rock show, Tony Award-winning musicals, a variety show. We're doing Frank Lesser in September, a night at the... Carlisle Black Tie Night, and then we're going to finish September off with the Night of Motown, which we haven't done since 2020. So that's going to be a lot of fun, too. And so many things I wanted to tell you, too. I forget everything right now. I saw someone else. Patricia's out there. Two Patricias out there watching us tonight. Thank you both. We have coming up, before I... I, oh, well, the, Yeah, I'll bring her. Let me bring the first picture, the old picture of Karen Gross and I at the old Odette's, just Karen and I. Do you have that handy? There you go. There's Karen Gross and I at the old Odette's at the front door, probably 30 years ago, I'm guessing. And let me say hi to Karen Gross, and then I'll show you our favorite picture of me and Karen. Karen, hi. Are you there? Oh, you there? Where are you? There you are. Look forward.
Hello. Oh, sorry. I should be looking here. Hi.
There you go.
Bob, Karen. It's always so great to be with you, and we have a lot of history. I think you're sharing it now. I'm blushing. I'm getting a little shy.
I know. I can't believe I found...
20 years ago, Bob.
It was what?
All these pictures from 20 years ago. It's amazing. How did that happen? Did we 20 think years passed.
Our wedding pictures from 20 years ago?
I would say it's at least like 15 years or so, yes. But we're still married, right? So,
I think
you know,
so. I don't
like
know.
No time has passed.
Show the picture, Christian. This
is true. Yes, show the picture.
Yes, there's Karen.
Hysterical.
There we are.
And I was playing the groom. It was a photo
No, there
shoot.
Was multiple grooms, though. Do you see that was like the joke
I know,
of the
I know. I remember that
it
was
hysterical.
The joke. So many choices, so little time. But she chose me.
Of course I chose you.
And your
yes,
mother was,
that was
so
easy.
Happy.
She Hi, was Barbara. So happy. Hi, Mom. Mom was our Yenta, actually.
Yes.
Mom introduced us.
Yes. She actually did.
She did.
Her mother had a wonderful healthy eat store that I loved going to.
That's right.
And she always told me about her daughter that sang. And I said what I probably said to every mother who has a daughter that sings, is she any good? And
that's right. Mom's my best agent, my momager. An agent, yes.
And anyway, the rest is history. And I got to listen to some of Karen's music. And then we became friends. And we did all kinds of different little shows and things together.
And I always have to like push Karen's blog because her podcast because she has this amazing podcast. You're everywhere. Every time I turn around, you're doing something incredible with
Thank
incredible
you,
women. You're finding stories of women who have been... Do I use the word overachiever? Because it feels like they all are.
That's kind of it. We're really trying to celebrate women who are rocking it. Yeah. The podcast is called She Rocked It. And every woman is really rocking it in her own way. But we all have something to learn from one another. And that was the idea, was to kind of open the doors to women's stories, hear how women are rocking it, what we can learn from one another. So check out, thanks for shouting that out.
Check out
SheRockedIt.com.
And you've like been facilitating discussions and been hosting chats and webinars and seminars. And every time I turn around, you're someplace fun.
Thank you, Michael. Right? You're like the best marketing person. Thank you. You're
Well,
hired.
He is a marketing
person.
That's what
marketing
I do.
He is a marketing person. I know.
That's because that's what he is, and so are
you're
you.
You're the best. That's
you
true.
Both are marketing and PR
that's
people.
That's true. And I just have to say, Bob, what you said earlier about us, like, you know, back in the day, I put today on my social media that you really were the one who gave me my start in the cabaret singing world back at Odette's. Like, when that picture was taken, probably was around that era that you gave me my first headlining show there, and that's what really opened the doors to my cabaret journey. So thank you, and thank you, Michael, for
you're
being
welcome.
Such a huge part of the journey
so
as well.
So glad you're here.
And
tonight.
You're singing more these days, because there was a while that you were sort of not...
Yeah, well, and obviously the past couple years were tough for all the music folks. So I sort of... You know, I'm just getting really throwing myself back into it and really combining my communications life with my singing life, because it's all communication, whether, you know, words or music. So, yeah, back at it big time.
Yeah, because if you don't know, Karen's an excellent writer and used to write for the local paper, but speech writing and creative writing and copywriting. And
like I said, you're like my marketing person. So this is amazing.
Your mother and I have been conspiring.
Exactly.
I think it's
thank
called
you.
Mutual Seriously. Admiration Society.
It is. That's so wonderful. Yeah, yes. Right. Communication that sings is my tagline, so bringing it all together.
And tell me what you're singing today.
Well, it was a variety show, and of course my passion is the music of the 60s and 70s, classic rock, especially because, you know, that was an era that taught us so much about love and peace and having hope in challenging times, and I feel like singing that music in this moment feels right. It reminds us that music can bring us hope and create change. So I wanted to sing two of my favorite songs in that regard.
She gave me
tonight.
A list this long to pick from. And
yes.
when we met up, we immediately went to these two. Like, we immediately were on the same page. We're like, we need to do
these. It's the complete opposite of what I do to Bob. Bob's like, what are you singing? I'm like, I don't know. And he's like, well, you better find out. I said, yeah, I don't know. Literally, because I'm like, and he knows that I'll have this block about Variety, because I'm like, he goes, why do you have a block about Variety? I said, you don't understand. When the world is your oyster, right? Mm-hmm. When you have every song, I find it hard. Give me a theme, and I could sort
you're
going like,
to just do Yacht Rock in. From now on.
Right.
Just be
yacht
the Yacht Rock
singer.
Yacht
Rock from now on.
That's your bag.
Not singing Yacht Rock tonight, Karen Gross.
Thank you. Next
Stevie,
time, though,
this is
I love
Stevie
Yacht
Wonder
Rock.
From one of my favorite albums of his, which I probably wore out. I think several people watching feel the same way. Mm-hmm. Songs in the Key of Life.
World's disaster could change your joy and laughter to tears and pain. It's that love's in need of love today. Don't delay, send yours in right away. It's gone too far. The force of evil plans to make you its possession, and it will, if we let it, destroy everybody.
That's a great song.
Love's in need of love today.
What more can you say, really?
1976.
Thank you, Stevie Wonder, for reminding us.
So this next song, it's really,
Talk about love.
Yeah, this is, I think if we all go back, we say there's places where we wish we could have been. Mm. I think everybody's got a list in their head. If I could go back, if I could be at, you know, one thing, Julie and Ken are watching, and Rebecca's watching, and my cousin Patty's watching too. I say, and you all probably are thinking the same thing as I'm thinking, Woodstock.
Okay, yeah.
I would love to have been in Woodstock, but in a Hyatt.
Well, I was reminiscing the other day because I went to Live Aid, right, in Philadelphia, and it was Yeah, and it came up on the memories that it was like, what, 40 years ago? Is that possible?
It's 30? Crazy. I think Live I just saw a clip 35. Of Madonna. Actually, Queen was at Live Aid, right? Wasn't Freddie Mercury did a famous performance
there, but he was in the London one, right?
Oh, okay.
I was in Philly.
You're in the Philly one, of course.
You know,
right.
I was 19 years old, 18 years old, something like that.
And that's cool you got to be there, though. That's pretty epic.
This is how I got to be there. I wasn't supposed to be there, okay? My brother was working at the Acme as a cashier, and he was on a radio call-in, you know, thing, and he won 2 tickets on the radio. And I thought,
oh my gosh,
I'm his brother. I've grown up with him his entire life. I am like, I share a room with him. He's going to take me. Wrong. He invited my cousin Joe.
What?
I know.
Not
I was
cool.
like, what the? So I said, you know what? Fine. Be that way. Well, as fate would have it, it was a union job he had as a cashier. He couldn't get off work.
Oh, my gosh.
So guess who went with Joseph to Live Aid? Me.
A little bit of karma.
And
karma. It's funny how that works.
It was funny. I was like, I said to John, you should have just asked me in the first place.
Oh my gosh.
So, but anyway, it was fun. It was hot. It was
the
like
Woodstock of our era.
It was actually because we got there at like 8 a.m. and we did not leave the stadium until after 1 probably. And it was just nonstop after nonstop. Every act that you thought should be there. Like, you know, what I remember most was Madonna. Mm-hmm. And I wrote this on Facebook. I said she had just been, her penthouse thing came out. It was a big scandal. So the first thing she said is she had a jacket on. It was like 110 degrees outside. She goes, I ain't taking X off today because she was, you know, because the scandal. And then Mick Jagger and Tina Turner doing Dancing in the Streets was just off the charts. Off the charts. And the stadium is rocking. And of course, Phil Collins did both London and Philly. And when he came on stage, there was a big roar. The whole day, though. I mean, Ozzy Osbourne, you know, he was there. Like, everything was, you know, Duran Duran and the Thompson Twins and all these acts that were like of that era.
Can we just do a Live Aid show, actually?
Wouldn't that be fun?
Let's do a Live Aid. Yeah. I'm thinking of all these great artists. We should do that.
Right. Look at the list of people that were there.
I just volunteered a new show concept. Sorry.
That's kind of cool.
Sorry.
That's cool. I don't know about that.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway. But yeah, it was fun.
But I remember it was the summer of 85 because I was unpacking 85. Boxes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'm 19.
From the house. Anyway.
I love it.
So, yeah.
Joni Mitchell, though, I have to say, it's so exciting to see her comeback because, speaking about not singing, she wasn't singing, is my understanding, for quite some time, right?
Right.
And to see her back and rocking it and inspiring people yet again with her voice as it is now is so profound. So I think, right? Isn't how exciting is that? I know for the Joni fans who are out there, we're all thrilled that she's still here. She's still, you know, the queen with us, sharing her voice.
And her Ladies of the Canyon album is epic.
Oh, so
epic.
Good.
And she just got a Kennedy Center honor, I think, last year.
That's right.
So she's, even though she's, what, 80, 81, something like that, she's in her prime in a lot of people's minds.
Yes, I agree.
A lot of people's minds.
And this song... reminds me of my friend Patsy. Mm. God bless her. This is one of her paintings, and I swear that's it's either Joni Mitchell in there or her imagining herself there, and it's all hippies singing like at a big party, like in probably the late 60s. And so it was just perfect that we decided to do this song, and the painting behind me is Patsy's painting, and I call her painting Woodstock.
Love it. Once again, Karen Gross.
We
are stardust. We are golden, and we've got to get ourselves back to the garden. I said, can I walk beside you? I've come here to lose the smog, and I feel to be a cog in something turning round and round. Well, maybe it is just the time of year, or maybe it's the time of man, I don't know.
Karen Gross.
Thank you to Bob Egan for those beautiful arrangements, for being such a big part of my journey. Thank you, Bob.
We just got carried away.
That was beautiful.
Which was kind of good.
That
right?
was a prayer.
Yeah, that's right. Thank you, Karen.
Thank you, Joni.
thank you, Karen.
Thank you, Patsy. Thank you, everyone involved to make that number happen. That was really good. I never played that in my life. When you first said you wanted to do this, I said, oh, not that. That's not going to work on the piano. And then
A lot of people working to make that number happen. A lot of people make every week happen here.
So thank you all for your amazing, amazing support. Every one of you that's has kept this show going from day one and continues to help. A long list of names, but you know who you are. You're all our angels. And I'll thank a few special people too. Sam and Happy Shipley and Kathy and Ted Fernberger and the Jekyll family and Ed McLaughlin and Joan and Rose and Dr. George and Donna and Sue DiCrescente, Julie Polonofsky, and anybody else I missed. I just love you all. Thank you. Marjorie, some of you people just have never missed a show, and you send the most amazing compliments to every time.
Absolutely. So thank you so much.
So we have two special guests for this next song. Two special guests. Yes, we do.
You haven't watched the video, have you?
I have no idea what I'm about to see. I was involved in the creation to a certain point, and then Michael took over.
So you could thank the two guests you know of.
I am going to thank the two guests I know of, and I sometimes we all like a good surprise, and tonight I'm one of them. So please welcome Pennycats and Freckles. Michael, you outdone yourself.
I couldn't help myself. I was here.
Right?
I was
right,
here,
Sharon? You know, well, good. Isn't that crazy what he does?
I was here last night just kind of thinking, what am I going to do? And then I promised Penny I'd come up with something special.
I guess you had a nap yesterday.
Yeah, seriously.
Was that a nap?
Or it's the coffee. I'm drinking coffee tonight.
How fun.
Because I had some left over from right before the show. I usually drink tea, which is back there. But the other day, the governor came to the theater, and I was supposed to meet him, and I was drinking coffee, and I spilled it all over my shirt.
Oh, no.
So I probably shouldn't be drinking coffee during the show. And so I had to, like, run to downtown New Hope to find a shirt. So maybe I should switch to tea.
Well, you have to look good to thank the man that fixed 95 in 10 days.
That's true.
A miracle. Anyway, thank you, Penny. That was so much fun. I love that song. That's one of the songs I played in my first piano bar job. We did old-time sing-along songs, and that was right in the top 10.
Did you have to dress up as an old-time piano player? Like, you know, seersucker and hats and...
No, I didn't really have any style, any sense of style or class down at all. Trust me, it was. I remember what I wore to my first gig, and I was not good. but you know, I was 18, so
live and learn.
Anyway, before we bring up our next special guest, I want to say hi to Maurice and Rick, who are out there, and they've been with us from day one also. And Tom Meany, it's always good to have you there, another fellow musician, wonderful flautist. And James Henry and the gang down at White Horse Village, and Dan and Dee. And Marie's out there watching us too, and Carol Silvoy and Tony Ruggieri, who's going to be on our show in a couple of weeks, Debbie Gwynn, Ed McLaughlin from South Carolina, and Vika is back in Florida. She's with us tonight, too. And Carol Silvoy. Did I mention Carol Silvoy?
Well,
I think I did.
Hi, Carol.
So, since we started the show, this young boy was in college, and he would sing his recordings in COVID from his dorm room once his roommates were out.
Yeah.
So, this is the first time I met him. We finally,
I thought he was not real.
I thought he was not real, but now he's working his butt off. He's appearing everywhere. And he knows how to dress nice, and he's like, he's got it all going on. So say hi to Zach Taglioli.
Hey, Zach.
Hey, virtual world. How's everybody doing?
There you are.
Zach is you are truly a young old soul.
I am.
No
I
doubt
am.
About
yes,
it.
Yes, that's my nickname, the old soul.
The old soul. And you graduated recently from Montclair, right? Was it last year?
Yeah, it was last year.
Yeah.
Last year, Montclair State University. And thanks to Joni Schneider, she was the one who told me about you guys, and I messaged away, and then I feel like you guys were a part of my college experience, because I would be on the show maybe every 4 months or so, or 3 months, or...
Yeah, sometimes...
Yeah, you were on the show a lot in the first year.
I remember one with a pizza box, for some reason. Well, I don't remember there being pizza in one of them. And
and Jack Daniels.
And Jack Daniels.
And Ed McLaughlin.
And at one point, you were courting Joni Schneider. Which, you know, kind of like we need to talk about that one. But yeah, you had a lot of fun. But you have a penchant for really great American songbook songs, right? Like you just love that music. It comes through in everything you do. And to have someone as young as you, far younger than anyone else in this room, it's amazing, because you're going to be keeping it alive for the rest of us, which is awesome.
Absolutely, Michael. I like to say that this music has been instilled in me since a young age, and it's been in and out of my life so many times. It's lasted longer than some of my relationships with women. But I'm not going to go there this evening. I say that for my shrink.
I think you just went there. Anyway, but I will ask you, you said it's part of your life. That when did you first start singing?
Really, I came out of the womb, and my mother said I just was crying and yelling, and I was like, that's me singing, Mom. That was just me singing. I can't remember a time I wasn't singing. I just was always singing around the house, and it just became second nature, and I never thought of anything of making it a career, but now it kind of is a career, and I'm happy for it.
That's awesome. So, and you are going to be singing two songs that really are perfect for an old soul like yourself.
I have a lot of audience. I know the names of the people watching that are going to love your choices.
So, yes. Zach Taglioli.
For many reasons.
Thank you.
Great songs. And both old classics, one from the 40s and one from the 50s. Mm-hmm. That's how we roll, Zach.
That's how we roll.
You ready?
I'm ready. Thank you.
fashion. I love the moonlight. I love the old-fashioned things. The sound of rain upon a window pane. The starry song that April sings. This year's fancies are passing fancies, but sigh and sighs, holding hands, these my heart understands. I'm old fashioned, but I don't mind it. That's how I'll always be. If only you'll agree to stay old fashioned with. The sound of rain upon a window pane, the starry song that April sings. This year's fancies are passing fancies, but sigh and sigh, holding hands, these my heart understands. I'm old-fashioned, I don't mind it. That's how I'll always be. If only you'll agree to stay old-fashioned with.
Too. What do you think?
Oh yeah.
And that's Irving.
They're loving you, Zach.
That's Irving Berlin, right?
No.
Who is that?
No, it's Jerome Kern and Johnny Mercer. Jerome and Johnny.
Johnny Mercer.
See, I
love Johnny Mercer.
I knew you guys are gonna love these songs. Peg and Jay are there too. Mm-hmm. And Sharon Bloodgood. These are all your kinds of songs, people.
Actually, I think there's a recording of Johnny Mercer singing that.
There is.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And Frank Kane. Frank Kane and I were just talking about that yesterday.
This is my favorite alcoholic drink, too. I love old fashions. Maker's Mark. A little Maker's Mark.
Bob said, I came down the stairs with my sport jacket, and Bob said, we have a bunch of Lushes here tonight. And now I'm beginning to see what he means.
That's all right.
Notice he says that after he takes
that's
a drink.
That's not true.
Yes.
No, we're more the Dean
Martin.
We
were just teasing. Just teasing.
No. But anyway, this next song is... I'm not going to tell you what the song is yet because we're just going to do it.
Yes.
But the man that made this famous was drunk at my piano bar in the early 80s when I was playing. And I just happened to have my fake book that it was in, and he signed it. Oh. It's somewhere behind where Michael is standing right
cool.
now.
Do you know which fake book it is? There's like 20 of them.
It's either A or B.
I don't know.
It's one of the real ratty ones. But on it, you will find the signature.
I'll see if I can find it during the
cut. Johnny Ray.
Okay. Once again, Zach Taglioli.
If your sweetheart sends a letter of goodbye, it's no secret, you'll feel better if you cry. When waking from a bad dream, don't you sometimes think it's real, but it's only false emotion that you. If your heartache seems to hang around, keep getting bluer with every song. Just remember, sunshine can be found behind a cloudy sky. So let your head down and go on and cry. That you feel. If your heartache seems to hang around too long, and your blues keep getting bluer with each song, just remember, sunshine can be found behind a cloudy sky. So let your head down and go on.
Tagliolli.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Bob. Thank you, Michael.
Thank you.
It's Williamstown. Thank you so much.
Williamstown, New Jersey's answer to Michael Bublé.
I know. Aileen loved it, right? Oh, thank you, Aileen.
Thank you so much, Zach.
Great song.
Come back. I know it's a schlep, but come back.
Thanks, Zach.
I'd love to.
I think everyone's going to petition for you to come back more often.
I will. I'll come back for the Yacht Rock.
Right, Wally?
The Yacht
Rock.
Yacht
Rock. All right.
I love it.
Now that you know how to get here, I know it's an hour, 20-minute drive from where you live.
All good. All good.
But,
I love the drive.
You know, we'll pay for gas if we have to.
Out of our budget?
I mean, somebody, no, it's not our budget, but somebody will sponsor your gas
that's
money.
True. That's true. That's true.
I can just see it. Somebody will send in something. It's just for Zach's gas money to come.
Zach's gas.
Because I did see your big truck, and I'm sure that's about 3 miles a gallon.
Well, thank you, Zach. Come see us
thank
again.
Thank you guys so much.
Zach Tagliolli.
Zach Tagliolli. The book, Michael, it was right to your left. It was right by your right hand.
Right. It's by my right.
It's right there. These. No, right there. It's one. No. Forward. Right there. It's that or the one in front of it.
I looked at them. Okay, give me
They're
a second.
They're both really raggedy.
They take me out for a second while, because I have...
One of those. Are you really want to just... They really need to see Johnny Ray's signature?
That's A, so it's on an A.
No, it might be an A.
Oh, it's on
it
the
might be an
page?
A. No, look in under C for cry.
Page 44.
I just want to tell people I don't make these stories up. Page 44. Hold on.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Hold on.
Zoom in.
There you go.
There it is. Johnny Ray.
Literally, when you said there were, it was in the fake book.
Hey, Sarah, you're a good kid. Came out.
I'm literally like, you said it was in a fake book, one of the old fake books. There are literally 30 old. I looked at Karen Gross at one point. I'm like, look at all the fake books. They were like all the way across. And how often do you even look at them anymore? Because it's changed so much. Music has changed the way we as performers get music. It's all digital. It's kind of crazy, right? So anyway, I'll put this back now.
A lot of people don't know my story as to why I have so much of my stuff scanned, and I'll tell you that real quick while our singer's getting ready. We have two last songs in the show, so we're not keeping you all night, don't worry. Not that you were worried. But during the Hurricane Sandy, where we are sitting here in New Hope, Pennsylvania, we're on a small grid of 11 houses that did not lose power for 1 second during Hurricane Sandy.
Which is a miracle because you know, so, we lose power, like a tree falls here and we lose power. It's crazy.
Hi, Vicki Morrison and Kathy Mestman. I just saw you're out there also. And so I came into the office that Monday morning, and my assistant at the time, Patty, and I were working. And she said, well, I said, well, we have power. We didn't lose power. And she said, well, we have no internet. We have no phone and no cable. She said, so I don't know what we're going to be able to get done, but we're going to do what we can do. And I was looking down at the floor at my 7 cases of music that I schlepped to every gig.
You really did.
And I said, Patty, get scanning. Here's how you scan. And we scanned over those 2 weeks, a couple weeks, we scanned like thousands of pieces of music. And I got rid of the cases, and I now show up everywhere with an iPad.
Literally, I remember because I carried those cases many, many years. There were at least 5.
There were 6 or 7.
Yeah, yeah. But I'm saying towards the end, there were at least 5 still, which is a lot. Because, I mean, we were like balancing cases. And then that didn't include the case you had for wedding music and one for classical music. And you had so many cases.
Bob's Big Book. Yes, one of those cases was all full of Bob's Big Book, which we're sing-along books.
You sort of looked like...
Right, Gretchen, you were there.
You sort of looked like you were doing the road company of a music man. You know, you were like a traveling salesman. So I have to tell you that Christian stars these comments. Have you seen some of these comments? So Debbie Gwynn was joining from her hot tub.
Oh, I like stories like that.
Okay.
Visuals. Yeah. Just a visual.
Visual. Carol Stillboy said, when I said, were you an old-time piano player? And she says, now you... He is an old-time piano player.
Oh, I am now, yes.
Yeah, it's kind of true. Debbie also, Debbie's full of wisdom tonight. She wants a Zach her age.
Oh.
I think a lot of women think that. Yeah.
Okay.
And Gail wants to know where Zach lives, which I think we said Williamstown, New Jersey. So we'll get him back. We'll get him back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Zach has a big repertoire too. He has a lot of songs, you know. So we can have Zach every week and never run out of songs.
Yeah. Oh, Patricia from Atlantic City. She remembers the books.
Because
you just slept them up when you were
I took them to the Ram's Head Inn when I first met her.
The Ram's Head, and then you were doing right, and then you were doing the resorts upstairs, and you had to take everything up there too.
Yeah, I was almost done with them by
almost,
resorts.
But geez. Yeah, a lot of books.
That was. Anyway, let's move on.
I know.
We have Claudia.
Claudia Perry. I may have to lower this because it's kind of like
Michael will do it. Adjust for her.
You know, I'm gonna adjust.
I kind of blend in with the wall wall paint, don't I?
It should be down there. That's okay. I can just move this.
And thank you, Christian. Thank you for being with us every night. Say you can say hi to everyone right now. Hey, Christian.
Hello.
Are you having fun tonight?
I am. It's been great. Yeah, it's been lots of fun.
I know last week we had Disney, so you knew all those songs, those Alan Menken songs. You were singing along. But tonight it was Yacht Rock in there.
I really have to do my homework on the Yacht Rock, admittedly. I'm going to find the Spotify channel tomorrow, I promise.
You're going to know every song.
I fear/hope that it's all like Peter Cetera.
Oh, some of it.
Steely Dan.
Steely Dan, yeah, right?
Hall & Oates.
Mm-hmm. Christopher Cross. I love Christopher Cross.
Christopher Cross. Yeah, it's a lot of good stuff. I had a whole dinner with my friends Sharon and Frank to Yacht Rock on Monday.
See?
At the shore.
See? Sharon. Sharon is definitely a Yacht Rock kind of. Yes. See? Bob skipped the 80s. See, skipped them.
I actually did.
Just stick to songs.
He literally skipped the 80s.
Yeah, I was learning Broadway and the Great American Song by Cole Porter and Gershwin, all that.
I literally paid no attention to the 80s
or radio.
Right. He's like, does Jerome Kern do Yacht Rock?
I never would say that.
I'm afraid I'd be stuck singing songs from the dinghy. Just more.
From the dinghy?
Yeah, songs from the dinghy.
What are songs from the dinghy?
How about Do You Know Baby Shark?
Yes, that's where my son would love
it. Baby Shark.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks.
All right.
Songs from the dinghy. That'll be a theme 1 week. Yeah.
Well, anyway, Michael, we got to move on.
I know.
We're running late.
Back for more.
We have 2 songs left. So we have Claudia Perry is back.
Hi.
Take a step to your right.
To my right?
Yeah.
This is my right. Oh. So you want me to go to my left?
You're left.
And he's drinking coffee.
There you go.
Can you see me?
I can see you.
Okay.
Barely, but I can see you. So you're singing a song from Smash.
Smash.
Smash. Mm. I love Smash because it has some really great music.
My favorite songwriters.
Yeah, some fabulous. So hold on, I'm actually going to change this.
Okay. Oh, yeah, that's better.
There you go.
Better?
Yeah. I'm just going to fix it that way.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So this, and this song was written for the, I think, the Marilyn Monroe character in Smash. Mm-hmm. It's a really fabulous song by
Mark Shaman.
Mark Shaman and Scott Whitman. Okay. Fabulous. Once again, Claudia Perry.
Clover, I saw the finish sign. I started as a rover, and the victory was mine. I thought the race was over, but they just keep moving the line. They cheered at my persistence, but prayed for my decline. The path of least resistance led to Hollywood and Vine. Tried to go the distance, but they just keep moving the line. I jumped all of the hurdles to break out of the pack. I started on the outside and then hit the inside track. I left the other fillies back at the starting gate. Was ready on my mark. I got to set to hurry up and wait. So talent and ambition won me a chance to shine. I aced the big audition, but it's raining on cloud nine. Can't beat the competition, cause they just keep moving the line. I handled every corner, each bump. Trophy. Well, the race began again, so I made friends with rejection. I'll straighten up my spine. I'll change each imperfection till it's time to drink the wine. I toast to resurrection, but they just keep moving the line. Please don't give me some direction, cause they just keep moving
the line. Yeah, Claudia Perry.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
Thank you
so much, Claudia.
Okay.
I love that. That's so much fun.
Great job. I love the songwriting. It's spirited and it's old fashioned, but yet it feels fresh. I love the songwriting.
You're ready, Michael?
I will be in a second. Any
and
last
now for
words?
Something completely different.
Well, you know, so here's the thing. So you.
So Claudia and I were talking earlier that Mark Shaman, who wrote that, also wrote Some Like It Hot.
He did.
Sure did.
He did.
Which is quite hot. So go see it.
Right. So when it came to a song, I said, I don't know what I want to sing. Pick something by Barry Manilow. So you picked this. And I was surprised you picked this. Was there a reason why you picked this one?
It just... As they say in Sweeney's Town, it just popped into me head.
It popped into me head. It's a nice song, and I it wasn't on my radar till tonight. So, little Barry Manilow. There you are. Looking just the same as you did last time I touched you. And here I am, close to getting tangled up inside the thought of you. Do you love him as much as I love her? And will that love be strong when old feelings start to stir? Looks like we made it. Each other on the way to another love. Looks like we
thought so until today, until you were there, everywhere. And all I could taste was love the way we made it. Love's so strange, playing hide and seek with hearts that always hurting. And we're the fools, standing close enough to touch those burning memories. And if I hold you for the sake of all those times, love made us lose our minds. Could I ever let you go? Oh no, we've made it. Left each other on the way to another love. Looks like we made it. Oh, I thought so till today, until you were there, everywhere. And all I could taste was love the way we made it. Oh, we made it. Looks like we made it. Today, until you were there, everywhere, and all I could taste was love the way we made it. Oh, looks like we made it. Oh, looks like we made it.
Thank you so much, Bob.
This is one of Barry Manilow's song you never did before,
never
right?
Never did it before, no.
Anyway, so where's our, we do our little...
We do our little goodbye. Someone left that. Why don't you guys go over there and just get at the other camera and say goodbye. Claudia went out, I think, to get some
air. Hi, Jacqueline and Steve. Good to see you out there, too. Thank you all for joining us tonight and celebrating our crazy mix of wonderful old songs and new and pop and a little bit of everything. Thank you so much for being with us tonight. And we'll see you next week for some Andrew Lloyd Webber. Wait.
All right.
Have a great week.